Hello everybody and welcome back to my channel. Guys, I know it's been a hot minute, but I promise the journey into the warning has not come to an end. We're back with more today as we dive into something else you guys have obviously been requesting a ton of for me to react to, and it is the performance of Almack's son from, this is going to test my Spanish skills from years and years ago and when I was in school. What is this? Tecate Pao Norte Festival. I probably butchered that. I'm so sorry. But I saw you guys have told me I could watch this one or Vivo. I'll probably do both of them, let's be honest. But I want to start with this one because I love having the crowd there, and it makes them... I really like to see how well Dani really, really performs with the crowd and like kind of gets them involved and stuff. She's so good at that. But regardless, I'm so excited to dive into this because I love these girls so much. They're so talented for just being three of them. And I love the sisterhood there and how much you can tell they have great chemistry. And it's just also awesome. So let's not waste more time, guys. Let's dive straight in. Here we go. That's a ton of people there. I love the support. Hell yeah. Hammer. Oh, that is a grungy guitar, damn. Ew. Oh, fucking hell. Oh my lord, girls. I must say, I love that we're doing this like studio version of it, because it really allowed them to take the dynamic of the song and give it almost this very stage-like feeling, where like I hear the bass guitar very much in my left ear right now, and I love that the drum is like everywhere. Like I hear like the one of the toms is over here in my right ear, but then like all around the back of my head, I hear the rest of the drum kit, which is just exactly what you want in a song. Because honestly, like with the days that we have now of like this spatial audio kind of thing, where like we almost get these like you know, headphones that can like give you like this 3D imagery almost of songs. You can hear like the actual true placement of like a song like this, or, like for a band. This would sound absolutely incredible with one of those headphones. I know that I have some back here that are actually hanging up over, well, it'd be over here, I think, if I do it the right way, because it's inverted. I think they're over behind me, but I don't know if you can see them. They're hanging up on my lamp right now. But they're like, oh, you have to download an app. I was like, well, I don't want to do that. No, I'll just find some that actually do it for me without having an app. But if you had those by chance, and they're a bit more expensive these days, but like if you have those, they would just would give you just a mind-blowing experience. You'd feel like you're being at the concert basically, or with the band on stage, and oh, it's just so cool. I love the dynamic of that. They just absolutely crushed that for this song. I mean, this is so good so far. Oh my god, every new song I'm listening to is getting better and better, let's be honest. Oh my god. I love Pal. She's the best. Yeah. Oh, gosh, Dani. God, everything is so crisp. It's all so good. My god. That's a cool shot.
God.
gosh, pal, my goodness gracious. She's got to be one of the best female drummers I've seen out there. I will put her up there now as probably one of my top three favorite female drummers now. For me right now, Akane is one of my favorites of all time. Akane is absolutely legendary. She is one of the best out there for sure. Juna from Hagane, I think is how you say their name. She is just joined that band, actually, but she is one of the best drummers I've had out there, too, before. And I actually am a big fan also of even the drummer for Nemophila. I also really love their drummer, too. But, I mean, I don't know, man. Pow is really up there for me. Just the way she plays it so passionately and just with so much power. Like, and the thing that's so nice about this is the fact that you really get to hear just how powerful and how incredibly just in rhythm she is because of just everything is, excuse me, everything is so clean, everything is so crisp. I mean, this is one of the best sounding drum kits I've heard in a song in probably my entire time I've been listening to rock in throughout my life. I mean, everything is just, it sounds like you're there, like in the room with her as she's playing it. That's how good it is. And that's when you know you got yourself a hell of a good sound engineer, you got yourself a hell of a good mixer, master, everything coming together perfectly. So major shout out to them for making these girls sound so damn good. But also just for that, they're all that good. They're all that talented also for that fact too. But damn, they're just, these girls, it just, I mean, it's probably just a testimony of how much effort they put in, how much work they put in for all of us fans to just give us the best fucking rock music we can get. I mean, it's just so damn good. Ah, it makes me so happy. Okay. Ugh. Get it, Ollie. Try not to think about it too much. The way the weight of everything's just unavoidable hurting. The way you hurt me's never enough. This addiction's hard to give up. If you want it all, then just take it. Oh, so good. Oh. Oh, get it, pal. Damn, girl. Look what you're doing, doing. Look what you're doing to me. Oh, damn. That was just incredible. Wow. Anything else? Is it done? I think it's done. Yeah, it's done. Oh my goodness gracious. That was just in fucking credible. Holy camoly. Now I'm really curious to see what he sounds like actually live. Because, I mean, hearing in the studio is freaking dope for sure. I guess hearing the studio version is awesome because it really gives you a good sense of, like, how everything here is clean, you know, and very, like, you know, mixed, mastered, you know, everything to the T. But I'm really curious to see how they sound this doing it completely live now. So I'm wondering, I think that Vivo is completely live too, but I'm not sure. But regardless, this, though, is a hell of a good song too. This one is definitely up there. What was the most recent one I did? Oh, yeah, Hell You Call a Dream. That's the most recent one I did. Yeah, and I said that one was my favorite one so far. I can't really say, honestly, that I think this one is beating that one out. I'd say it's up there as just as good as that one for me. I think that for me, which is really nice with these girls, is, like, every new song I hear is getting better and better for me, which is awesome. Because at first, it was like, after hearing what they were doing with Bandmate, I was like, okay, I could get into these girls. And then it was like, after hearing one song, it was like, okay, now I'm an avid, you know, fan. Then it was like, okay, I'm a pretty good fan now. Now I'm like, just like maybe one more really good song away from just like, I am sending it and I'm going to like listen to every single song of theirs ever put out. I mean, these girls are so fucking incredibly good. It's just insane. I mean, it blows my mind. It's literally just three of them, and yet they sound like a full, like, 5 or 6 member band with, like, 2 guitarists and, like, a bassist and, like, a drummer and maybe a, you know, another singer or something like that. I mean, it's just, they rock out so freaking hard. It's amazing. I mean, my gosh. I mean, I guess it just shows that when you really, truly love, have a passion for something like that, at such a young age, you know, and you take it on and do it for your entire life all the way up to the point now where they're like 20s, I think is how old they are, they're in their 20s or something like that. I mean, it just shows what 20 years of like hard, well, I guess technically it's more like 10 years since they were not like 10, they were like infants when they started. You know, still, about 10 years of hard work put in is what you get from that. I mean, you get just incredibly well-written songs with incredible guitar, incredible bass, and incredible drum set. Or drum, you know, rhythm. I mean, they just rock out so hard. And honestly, I really love being a fan of them now. I mean, honestly, like, I can't thank Bandmade enough for introducing them to me, honestly. And for you guys for keeping me on the journey and telling me how good they were. Oh my gosh. Anyways, I cannot wait to hear the next song now going forward. I pretty much hit the big three. I know what you guys are asking for. I'll have to go back to the first video because the first run I did for these girls, you guys suggested a lot of stuff. So I'll have to go back through and read those comments again and see what else you guys wanted. But of course, fill me in on us. What else you want me to react to in this comment section too. So, as always, guys, I will go ahead and, I guess I'll say I'm going to go ahead and wrap this video. So, if you enjoyed this video, go ahead and drop a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and then, of course, I'll go ahead and drop my reactions playlist for these ladies over here so you guys can check out my other reactions if this is your first one you're seeing from me. And more than anything, thank you all so, so much for watching, and I will see you guys in next video. Alrighty, guys. Bye!